One of the first things I remember ever doing musically was that I was playing with my grandma, because she was a really good piano player. She didn't have any education for playing, but she played really, really well by ear. And we were rehearsing some like Christmas tunes. But then I was like maybe 7 or 8. We started our first rock band, and then it kept going. But then I was from a really, really small town, and everybody more or less played the same music. So I got, when I was late teens, like maybe 17 or something, I got really bored with the music environment I was living in. And I happened to spend 1 year in United States, and I was things led to other things, and I found myself touring with the Grateful Dead, the legendary psychedelic hippie rock band from the 60s. And that was the first time I got to come across with the folk music, because they used folk songs in their music, and also long improvised things. So when I got back to Finland, I started to process this, and I was actively trying to look for things to do, things, musical things differently that I have done before. And then I was, because I got curious about folk music, that if there's such music in USA, then there must be something similar in Finland as well. So I started to actively look for something about Finnish folk music, and I had this book about Finnish folk music, and I opened it, and there was like a chapter called Jouhikko, and I, whoa, what is this? It has like 3 strings, and you can only play like 5 or 6 tones with it. And I kind of, it started immediately resonating in me that this is what I really, really would like to experiment. Because I was really frustrated to play guitar, because there's too many notes. But the 5 or 6, it sounded like really, really excellent. This I can learn. And then from that on, slowly, things led to another things, and I'm here.
And tell us something about your own music instrument. Did you change something, or it's an ordinary one, or it's what happened with it?
Well, in a way, a lot of things have happened, and then in the end, not much have happened, like instrument technically. But when I started to play, first year I started to play jouhikko, I was playing on the streets with my friend who's a bagpipe player. So he had really, really super loud instrument, and my instrument was super, super not loud instrument, a super quiet instrument. So I had to buy a small amplifier and a microphone system, but the amplifier was so small, so I had to put it like full power, so the sound was distorted anyway. So that was kind of my starting point. But of course, at one point I searched more like kind of nice acoustic sound, and then more like electrified and powerful, strong, this like loud sound. But nowadays, then we developed this like electric jouhikkos, which like serve the purpose of playing loud really, really nice. You can play with the drummer and with loud instruments, and it doesn't like leak into your microphone systems, and it doesn't like feedback all over the place. So those kind of small things, but in the end it's like a good acoustic instrument, and from that. Well, I have done music since I was a small boy, I think it's like this. I have still the same feeling that I was 8 or 7, that you kind of discover these silly things and you play, you know, that if I do this, what happens, and if I do that. So it's kind of course I do it like professionally now, and I have to make my living kind of from music, so I can't fool around all the time, but still the kind of inventing stuff and composing is a lot of like a game, or this kind of challenge and somehow. And it's really weird. It's really, really difficult to describe the process, but there's it's like this endless path with full of like surprises and wonderful things that I want to experience myself first and then to kind of share it. And because I have done it since I was so small or young, so I don't know much about anything else, so it's like my own thing.
Was somebody who influenced you, and where you find inspiration for music?
Well, all over. It's if you travel to new places, you kind of have your ears open, and of course I listen to a lot of music in general, so it's kind of this constant process of going through things and taking something in. But the band called Grateful Dead was my main main influence. But then I spent like hundreds of hours in archives listening like archive Finnish folk music. So there's lots of like singers who have already died maybe 50 years ago or something that I have never met. But still they are really, really familiar to me because I've been listening to their stories and to the sound and their music before. But Feodor Fratsu, I have tattooed here, it's one of the last jouhikko players from Karelia, so he's one of the main heroes I have.
Yeah. You play also in different projects?
Yeah. I play a lot with Anne-Marie, who is there in her projects. We have now, she has a new group called Anne-Marie Kivimäki and Palomyl. And we just released a new album, and it's been really, really nice. And I play in her, the latest band, I play fiddle, which is, I think it's really, really funny because I'm not the fiddler in any way, but I like to play. But because I started to play violin after I started to play jouhikko, so I played in, I think, really like jouhikko way, and not like this, but somehow here.
I have done some like featuring things with the metal bands, but I haven't done myself. I haven't yet done like really. I have kind of put in some like metal, I think, influences in all my albums. So they are a little bit like this. I think like more 70s heavy metal, like Sabbath routine stuff, than from the more contemporary. But I was some years ago I was visiting with Amorphis from Finland, and then also like some like smaller metal bands from Finland.